What's up, guys? Welcome back to NewsWave. So this weekend, we do have the Xbox Game Showcase, and wouldn't you know it, a couple of big games that were going to be announced there leaked out early, and we'll go over some of those here today. Also, we are going to be talking about Summer Game Fest with a bunch of games that were revealed, and we're going to attempt to cover every single announcement that was made, and we're also going to be talking about what's next for Nintendo, as it does appear that The Legend of Zelda is closing in on that big movie contract. Guys, if you enjoy these videos, make sure you hit that like button. Helps out a ton. And if new here to the Spawn Wave channel, make sure you subscribe down below. And we're going to start today with Friday the 13th and how it looks like it's coming to an end for this asymmetric multiplayer game. We can see this posted up over on Twitter under the Friday the 13th account saying the time has come. Our license for Friday the 13th will expire on December 31st, 2023. On that date, Friday the 13th, the game will no longer be available for sale, both physically and digitally. So being pulled completely off of the storefront there. The game will continue to function though through December 31st, 2024, at which point the servers will be shut down completely. And it really just goes to show you that yes, these always online games typically do have an expiration point, this one being no different. And obviously having the licensing, all of that kind of involved, this was gonna happen, and unfortunately it's sooner rather than later. I never got into the Friday the 13th game at all, but I know RGT got really into it and enjoyed it. So for fans of the game, it is a shame to see. They mentioned they're going to be dropping prices for the game and the DLC. So I guess if you've been curious about this game, you can check it out, see what you think, at least for the next year or so. Remember, that will be ending overall for service December 31st, 2024. Oh, and of course, we do have Capcom Showcase next week on the 12th, as we had discussed yesterday in NewsWave. However, Capcom has updated their site, showing off some of the different games we can expect, and you can see this posted up over on their website. We have Ghost Trick, Phantom Detective, that's actually coming up here pretty soon, and it makes sense they'd want to put at least a bit of a spotlight on what's more of a niche title overall. Exo Primal, again, makes sense. It's what we figured would be there since it is releasing next month and will be going directly into Game Pass. And then Dragon's Dogma 2, which, hey, for Dragon's Dogma fan, probably really, really happy to see more and more emphasis being put on this sequel. Otherwise, though, it just says, and more. So while they're at least discussing some of the games we can expect, seems like they still have a few surprises up their sleeve. And I still think the big reveal would be a new Monster Hunter game, and it kind of feels like they should be getting to that point now with Monster Hunter Rise being very successful, but kind of running its course at this point. But we'll see what Capcom has for us again on June 12th. Oh, and here's a bit of a left field announcement. Croc HD. This was in response to kind of an article going over the history of Croc and sort of a retrospective on it, but you can see this posted up over on Twitter. This is from the Argonaut founder, Jez San, who says, I have news, but it's a little premature to announce it. A Croc HD has started early development, and at this point, why not? We're seeing a lot of games, yes, from that generation. I mean, well, Pac-Man World, that was random, right? But for the most part, we're seeing a lot of these older games get remasters and find new audiences because, I mean, really, generations have cycled through of new gamers coming in to where the Switch might be their first system that they themselves have owned. So why not take some of these titles, modernize them a bit, obviously with visuals, but also controls, and see what you can get done with that, and maybe that can lead to more iterations of it, because of course there is Croc 2, but maybe just a brand new game in the Croc franchise. What a world that would be. And guys, with some of the quick news out of the way, let's get into the bigger stuff. Let's start right away with a major leak, an unfortunate leak, especially for Microsoft, as they seem to have a pretty exciting couple of surprises here set up, even though it's been rumored and talked about, and URLs have been updated, and people have kind of passed this around as, yeah, most likely it'll be there. Now it's pretty much confirmed all the way down to the full trailers leaking online, and that's for a couple of Persona titles that I think people are going to be pretty excited to hear about. We can see this, though, post up over on Gamatsu after everyone really started to notice and pass around that Atlus just happened to post trailers on their Instagram account. Now, the strange thing is these are for games that have not yet been announced. That's Persona 3 Reload and Persona 5 Tactica. Now, Persona 5 Tactica, according to the trailer, is set to release November 17th, 2023, and Persona 3 Reload is set for early 2024. You can kind of tell by the titles what they are. Obviously, Persona 3 Reload being that remake for Persona 3 that we have been hearing about for quite some time, and we're already kind of lining up for it to be announced at the Xbox Games Showcase. Persona 5 Tactica, though, appears to be, as it sounds, a strategy-based RPG. This, though, being in the Persona 5 universe, and from some of the bits of gameplay that they showed, it looks like your standard strategy RPG, moving around and affecting different quadrants of the map based on your abilities and attacks. I can't necessarily show you any of these trailers because Atlas, I'm sure, is going to be trying to run Damage Control cleanup as much as they can, as these trailers are being passed around everywhere. I'll just show you some Persona 5 trailer footage or something here. But with Persona 5 Tactica and Persona 3 Reload being shown, there was something else interesting at the end of the trailer. These both appear bound for Game Pass day one, which, once again, that's a big time pickup for Microsoft as they work to just expand the overall scope and variety of Game Pass. Remember, they have to keep putting in as much as they can in terms of all the different genres and everything, and they have worked with Atlas and Sega in the past, clearly with the other Persona games that just happen to go right into Game Pass. So I think these are some big time reveals. It's just unfortunate, I guess, that Atlas decided to randomly upload them to their Instagram account. It could have been set up on like a scheduled timer, and for some reason it was just off time zone differences, although that's pretty far off then, because it posted up yesterday on Thursday randomly. So hey, there we have it. We do have some Persona stuff to look forward to at the Xbox Game Showcase, but it should also make you think of what else they have set up, because this is certainly something you wouldn't necessarily expect to see at an Xbox Game Showcase. I feel like right now Microsoft is lining up a pretty good show for Sunday, so I'm looking forward to it. I will also be streaming that Xbox Showcase, so come on by. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Next up, let's talk about Summer Game Fest and the showcase that ran for about an hour and 45 minutes, and there were a lot of game reveals here, several different titles being showed off. I counted 41 different games that were either revealed or got an update, as well as a couple of trailers for like TV or streaming series, so we're going to go line by line here, starting at the top with Prince of Persia: The Lost Crown. It's a 2D Metroidvania game from Ubisoft, January 18th. We'll see more about this at Ubisoft Forward next week. And I like what I'm seeing here. 2D Prince of Persia, while we're still waiting for the Sands Time remake that sounds like it's a ways off, pretty cool to see something that definitely is a callback to some of the old original Prince of Persia games. Mortal Kombat 1, as promised, we did get a bunch of gameplay, a lot of information here. Some about the cameo fighters. They'll work into your own combos, which does include the X-ray combos, it seems like. You press a button to bring them in, and you can alter the different moves according to what they were saying here, based on maybe a direction on the D-pad or something that you press. And you have two different character select screens, one for your cameo fighters, one for your main fighters, and fatalities look ridiculous, as you'd expect, and I'd say visually it looks pretty good. So exciting stuff there for Mortal Kombat fans. Looking forward to that one when it launches in September. Then we had Path of Exile 2's full gameplay there. They have some more information coming to us July 28th. Street Fighter 6 is having an Exo Primal crossover. For some reason, sure, why not? As fall 2023, they showed Ryu and Guile. They're going to be fighting and punching dinosaurs in the face. Nicolas Cage showed up on stage to promote Dead by Daylight. Now, that's happening July 25th, where Nicolas Cage will be a character in the asymmetric multiplayer game. So, sure, why not? The Witcher Netflix series, there's a trailer for that, season 3 coming up. Witchfire, September 20th, early access. Crossfire Sierra Squad, that's on the PSVR 2, August 2023. Remnant 2, that's July 25th. Sonic Superstars, this one was a bit of a surprise to see a new 2D Sonic game here that wasn't Sonic Mania 2, but fall 2023, play as a bunch of different characters, has a very distinct art style to it, kind of that 2.5D look, almost similar to Sonic 4, I guess. They also mentioned abilities and stuff, so pretty cool to see a new 2D Sonic game here. Honkai Star Rail, that is heading to the PS5 Q4 2023. Lies of P, we got the release date for that, September 19th, as well as a demo that is available right now. Sandland, this has Akira Toriyama involved, as using Unreal Engine 5, something to keep tabs on there. Although they mentioned it's from a manga, I'm not familiar with that manga, but hey, there you go, Sandland. Annapurna, there will be an interactive showcase coming up here, and they also seem to tease Silent Hill, which they are working on a game with Konami there. So interesting stuff to see that one. Throne and Liberty, it's from NCSoft and Amazon Games. Warhaven, that's from Nexon, it's fall 2023. Party Animals, September 20th, 2023. Crash Team Rumble, of course, that's coming up June 20th. Alan Wake 2 gameplay, October 17th, of course, on this one. And they went over some new details for it. The two playable characters, Saga is the new character there alongside of Alan. It's split 50-50 between their stories. And apparently you can just pick which character you want to follow their story completely through. And then you go back to the other character. So you can kind of tell the stories in whatever order you would prefer. It is a sequel, of course, but they mentioned you can play it as a standalone game. I guess they've put some information in there maybe to catch you up if you missed the first one there. I'd say it's visually impressive. The foliage looked good as they're walking through the initial environment in the forest, and it seemed like parts of the environment was very interactive and destructible, especially when you run into that first enemy and it blows right through the wall. And I'd say it has a bit more of an action vibe to it compared to the first one. Almost adopted a bit more of that RE2 remake kind of viewpoint in all of this. Warhammer Space Marine 2, we had gameplay, co-op campaign, three players, winter 2023. Yes, Your Grace, that's coming out 2024. Toxic Commando, it's a zombie horde shooter with vehicles, it's 2024. Baldur's Gate 3, that'll be leaving early access going into 1.0, August 31st, 2023. And then we had Spider-Man 2 appear on stage. They showed us the box art immediately with that first title card and artwork there. I think it looks really, really good. And they also discussed Venom and how clearly from what we've seen so far, Peter has the symbiote, but eventually it would leave him. And there is concept art of Venom, as we know Venom, big bulky Venom there. But according to them, it's not Eddie Brock Venom. So the big question now is, who is Venom in this game? They said they wanted to make an original story, and that's going to be a big reveal in the game. So exciting stuff there. And we got the release date, October 20th, 2023. Very strange that we get the release date here, but not at Sony's showcase. But hey, better late than never, I guess, on this one, right? The strange thing, though, and I guess something that's kind of been a trend for Sony, is the special edition that they showed off will not have a physical copy of Spider-Man 2, which is very frustrating, annoying, all of this, but that's kind of how Sony has been doing things with a lot of their big special editions. Pal World is described as Pokemon with guns, and that's exactly what it looks like, although they did have missile launchers too. January 2024 for early access. Black Desert, that's Land of the Morning Light, June 14th. Lord of the Rings, Return to Moria, is coming up. Final Fantasy VII Ever Crisis, June 8th for the closed beta. It is a mobile game. Don't worry, Final Fantasy fans, we got something else coming up. Banishers Ghosts of New Eden 2023. Like a Dragon Gaiden. This, of course, I'm sure got a lot of Like a Dragon fans excited. November 9th on that one. Under the Waves, August 29th. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 Season 4 starts June 14th, coming up here next week. There was a commercial for Porsche for some reason. Apparently doing a giveaway with Xbox where they showed an interesting looking Xbox, we'll say, that's going to be given away. Fae Farm, that's September 8th. Marvel Snap, Conquest Mode going into the game. King Arthur, Legends of Rise. Wayfinder, it's early access this summer. Stellaris Nexus. Space Trash Scavenger. Star Trek Infinite. Twisted Metal TV series, they showed a quick trailer for that, July 27th. We have Lise Fanga, that's 2023. Immortals of Avium, Doom with Magic, as they described it, and that's kind of what we've been hearing as we've gone along up to its July 20th release date, so we're a little over a month out. I will say, I'm interested in this game. I'll check that one out, at least give some of my thoughts on it. Fortnite Wilds as Optimus Prime, so exciting stuff there for Transformer fans. And then we closed out with the big reveal, Final Fantasy VII Rebirth gameplay. The world looks big, which is great. You'd expect that since we're now outside of Midgar. Red 13, they showed them as being playable, so awesome. And then it is early 2024 on two Blu-ray discs, which is good to hear because that means that even if the game exceeds 100 gigabytes, we'll have another disc kind of back things up rather than make us download potentially 50 or 60 gigabytes. Looking up and down the card here, though, of announcements, I would say for the most part, fitting 41 different game announcements and a couple of TV series into roughly an hour and 45 minutes, while it did have some low points, some slow areas, and some games looking very, very similar, especially with the medieval concept, I think it was one of Jeff's better Summer Game Fest, although he hasn't really been doing it for very long, but I think the pacing was fine. I feel like the live audience at least worked or didn't get in the way necessarily, and the people he brought on stage made sense, and he kind of moved them along quickly enough. So, for the most part, I would grade this right around a B. So, let me know what you think about Summer Game Fest, though, down below, and of course, that was part of our poll question we have coming up later on. And in our last bit of news, let's talk about Nintendo's next big movie that could be coming up after the massive success for the Super Mario Bros. Movie, and this appears to be including the Legend of Zelda franchise, which I think most of us figured would be next up after Super Mario Bros. We can see this posted up. This is over on consequence.net, but they are quoting the Hot Mic podcast with Hollywood insider Jeff Snyder, who says, "I'm told that Universal is in fact closing a big deal with the Nintendo Corporation for the Legend of Zelda. Zelda is looking like the next big Illumination Nintendo franchise, which we are all sort of expecting. I'm told that is happening." However, he went on to say that it will cost Universal a pretty penny following the massive success of Super Mario Bros. Movie, which has raked in over $1 billion worldwide, and it is on its way to becoming the highest grossing video game movie adaptation, or really the highest grossing animated film. I think it's still right, it's behind Frozen 2. People are wondering if it'll catch it, considering it is out on like Blu-ray and stuff here pretty soon. It was a strange rollout for that. The Super Mario Bros. Movie was in stores on Blu-ray before they had announced it going to stores on Blu-ray. It's very weird. But either way, it could still maybe just eke out past Frozen 2, but doesn't really matter. It is a massive success for them. And clearly, the next one up would get Nintendo even more money because they're going to ask for more upfront, since I'm sure there is a massive bidding war going on behind the scenes. However, if it's Illumination, that means we don't have to worry about them attempting anything live action with The Legend of Zelda. And I think Illumination style could work really well with a Zelda movie. I'd be curious, though, how they would deal with Link not really saying much at all other than some grunts here and there, but I think there could be some awesome scenes that could happen here in the forest with the Master Sword, maybe time travel with Link growing up. If they put the care and attention into it like they did with the Super Mario movie, yeah, I think they could have a really, really compelling movie here with The Legend of Zelda. But if they're still negotiating it, we're probably a ways off from actually seeing what they come up with. But exciting stuff nonetheless, and maybe that means Nintendo can explore some of their other franchises, even if it's not necessarily on the big screen, through different TV series and streaming. Still crossing my fingers that they attempt something Metroid-related with that. And before we go to the comment of the day, we're going to take a look at the poll that I posted up yesterday, where I ask, give Summer Game Fest a grade. B at 44%, C at 32%. That seems about right. I mean, you could kind of teeter between B or C. A at 8%, D at 9%, F 7%. I'm not really sure I'd give an F if Final Fantasy VII Rebirth closed out with full gameplay. And that was the biggest thing, is there was actual gameplay here. There was a considerable amount, since we're so used to seeing so much CGI at a lot of these showcases recently. To have gameplay pretty consistently throughout and have so many titles shown, that's why I'm coming in with a B on this one. But I understand if the announcements aren't there for you and you're not really interested in much of what's being shown, it's very easy to just be like, nah, it wasn't a good show at all. But to me, objectively looking at the structure and how much they showed off, again, I thought it was one of Jeff's better shows overall. And we'll finish up with the comment of the day, as you're seeing here. This is from James, who says, "I just want the Final Fantasy 16 demo later and the Persona 3 remake announced somewhere." Well, hey, good news for Persona 3 remake. He made this comment before it got leaked out all over the place. Tune in for the Xbox showcase. You should be pretty happy there. Coming early 2024, I think. But for Final Fantasy 16 and the demo, it was very odd, because I thought that would have been the push for Square at this Summer Game Fest, not 7 Rebirth. But here we are with 7 Rebirth having that early 2024 announcement and nothing about the 16 demo. I guess they're just eventually going to post up on Twitter, "Hey, Final Fantasy 16, the demo's ready." It's not going to be at the Xbox showcase, obviously, so maybe that's the way to go, because if they just put it out on Twitter, people are going to download it anyway. They don't necessarily need a showcase announcement for 16 demo and people to get all excited about it. But still, with the big marketing push they've had behind 16, it's a little surprised they didn't try another one here at Summer Game Fest. And ladies and gentlemen, that's going to do it here for Newswave. If you enjoyed this video, guys, hit that like button. If not, hit the dislike. Leave comments down below about everything we talked about here today, whereas Atlas just couldn't hold off, could they? Had to tell us about some of these Persona games that apparently we'll be seeing at the Xbox Game Showcase. Let me know if you're excited for that one. And also, Summer Game Fest, what'd you think of it? What's your letter grade? And The Legend of Zelda seemingly next up for a movie adaptation from Illumination. Do you think they can pull it off? Thanks, guys, for watching. Have a great weekend. Come on by the Xbox Game Showcase. We'll be streaming it. I think it'll be a lot of fun. And if I don't see you there, I'll see you next Monday, 8 a.m. Eastern Time for Newswave.